Before this video begins, be sure to check out my video regarding of the questions and answers. Basically, make sure to write down all your questions in that video. I will leave links down below in the description and also in pinned down the comments. Thank you so much and enjoy this video. Happy Christmas, everybody. Well, currently is this recording is actually more like Happy Christmas Eve, but I just want to mention Happy Christmas, everybody. Have a fantastic day as well, and hopefully you're gonna have a lovely dinner with your family and all, and I know I'm gonna be having that as well, and please enjoy your presents that you have recently received, and overall, happy Christmas. So today I wanted to talk about Hellblade 2 Senua's Saga. Basically, this time around, I wanted to talk about regarding that this game is only exclusive on the Xbox and PC as well. This, just so you know, Xbox does not refer to be as an Xbox Series X only. This could be also coming on the Xbox One as well. Now, there's no concrete evidence about that, but there is definitely confirmation regarding it. It will be only exclusive to these consoles, but PlayStation 5 or PlayStation 4 will not be getting this game at all. This kind of sucks in my personal opinion, because I really did enjoy the first Hellblade, and it was my one of my favorite games, and I definitely wanted to see a sequel for it, even though I kind of think that the story kind of wrapped up nicely. I don't see how this would have even gotten a sequel. Kind of makes no sense in some cases, but whatever. I'm still looking forward to see how it will perform, how will it do. Now, just so you know, this is actually confirmation coming from Aaron Greenberg. He's currently general manager of games marketing for the Xbox. And of course, this means that he has very big ties in with the Microsoft, so obviously you will know these answers. And pretty much he himself on a Twitter referred it and mentioned that this is exclusive on the Xbox and PC, as you can see currently in front of you. Now, I want to state and bring in my opinion about this as well. I don't want to say, for example, I'm kind of disappointed the fact that we're not going to be getting Hellblade 2, because to be honest with you, I'm not that disappointed. Like, I still have my opportunities of playing this game on a PC, because I'm still not thinking about getting the Xbox Series X or whatever, the Xbox in general, just to play this game. So far, because the game did not come out and I can't say for sure if it's going to be great or it's going to be trash. Who knows? But in a lot of ways, since we are talking about Ninja Theory and Hellblade, so a lot of people expect it to be fantastic. Now, I'm definitely looking forward to see how it will perform and with the reviews and stuff like that, but if it does end up being a very good game, it needs to have a lot more incentivization, at least for me, to pick it up. Now also, if I would actually make a purchase, for example, get an Xbox Series X as an example, and get this game and maybe a few other titles such as like Halo Infinite as an example, because obviously it's exclusive as well on the Xbox and of course the PC on top of that. So this does not necessarily mean that I'll be getting the Xbox Series X just solely for the Hellblade 2. But this does not also mean that I will be getting the console because of these two games. No. If there are somewhat even good performed, very good reviews, this still does not mean that I'm just gonna go ahead and pick it up just like that. No. For me to do that, to make that step, that leap of fate, so to say, right, is actually when the game is bloody masterpiece. For example, God of War. God of War was solely alone good enough to be even purchasing a PlayStation 4, whatever the console, PlayStation 4 Pro or the Slim version, just to play God of War, because it was worth every penny. That's the reason why I think it should have, like you see, this kind of game is a fantastic, it's a masterpiece game as well, like a lot of people think as well on that top of that. But of course, Xbox gamers are not going to be, you know, seeing it as such, because obviously they never had to go at it, or they're like, you know, pretty pissed off they don't have these sort of the exclusives on the PlayStation 4 that could have got an opportunity of playing it so similar on their Xbox. Because so far, all the exclusives that did come out on the Xbox, there was completely no incentivization for anybody to pick up these games, and that sucks. Demon's Souls, as an example, that rumored at the moment that is still coming on the next generations of console, it's also most likely will be exclusive on the PlayStation 5 if it was being, well, it is being developed by Bluepoint Games. Bluepoint Games are more or less, they always publish their games, always release their games, I should say, exclusively on the PlayStation. And a lot of people, for some odd reason, as well, say that it will most likely come out at the launch of the title as the PlayStation 5. It's very possible indeed, but I don't mind it either way, because I'm still gonna get my hands on it. Like, obviously, I'll be picking up on day one the PlayStation 5, and I don't know yet anything about the Xbox Series X, because so far what incentivized me of getting these the console, I should probably phrase that, is just these two games, Halo Infinite and Hellblade 2. But the issue with that, of course, I don't know how the reviews are going to be, approaching of it. But to be honest as well, it's a subjective thought. It's my opinion alone. I can't be for certain. I might be wrong about a few things as well, because, as an example, I am more of a fan of a PlayStation more than Xbox. Well, to be honest, it's not because of the consoles or the name or the brand. It's because of the games. That's just solely alone. That's really is. If Xbox would have had fantastic games, like with a comparison or like a difference compared to, like say, Xbox One X, as an example, would have had all these God of War, like Days Gone, as an example, Death Stranding, blah, 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 so many other games, of course. Obviously, I would have been already playing on the Xbox, not PlayStation. That's obvious. Like, if there would have been a vice versa, like a transition of both of the things, like a swap. Now, obviously, that's not the case. That's not the reality. The best games are on a PlayStation 4 at the moment, but there was still 2019, and it's already coming to an end. 2020 coming, and we already know what are the better games coming out as well. PlayStation got, what was it called? Ghost of Tsushima is an example, and The Last of Us. These two games alone are exclusive on the PlayStation, and they're already worth picking up the damn PlayStation 4 because of these two games. You see what I mean? Like, it's insane. Why would I make that kind of transition over to an Xbox if there's so many fantastic games on the PlayStation that just simply, like, all the exclusive games combined can't even come up to close being on the similarity to The Last of Us. All of those exclusives. Now, Halo, whatever, Forza is an example, right? And Gears, I'm not denying that those three games are very good, but they're same always, the same thing again and again and again. PlayStation have new IPs. That's what makes it even more special, because more unique for you to come back and keep on playing different things every time. You may think they're shit, some think you may think it's great. That's the thing of risk and taking. That's what matters, in my personal opinion, of course. Xbox does not seem like they want to make any risks. Well, at least at the moment now, they finally are doing these things, such as like the risk takings, and that's good, finally, right? But wow, what the hell happened there 5 to 7 years back? Like, where were the games, for example? And so obviously a lot of people are very hesitant and skeptical about Xbox, and obviously, right? Because like, feels like so far the Xbox has made these so many studios that are under their wings anyway. Just my way of saying things, for example, guys. So basically, when the Xbox took so many of these studios, and basically so far, whatever they have published, all of the games, they were not that great, as like coming on the Xbox solely as an example, right? For because the Bleeding Edge as an example, right? I don't personally like it. I don't like the way it looks personally. Just in my opinion, of course. And for example, The Outer Worlds, but that came out on every platform. But yes, it was only recently taken, and Obsidian, right? Right now they're with the Xbox, so their next game is going to be Xbox exclusive, and of course PC as well. But this only gives me an idea, maybe not an idea, but already gives me a reason why I should not pick up the Xbox, the next Xbox as well. Why I should do is just get better graphics cards or CPU as an example. I already have a very good CPU and a graphics card. I could just play all these games once in a while on my PC. And plus, it's a much better version and the option for me to do so. But I'm not gonna deny that, for example, the next Xbox is gonna be a very, very powerful console, 60 FPS, and with the open world games, hopefully. Again, that was not exact confirmed in details, but yes, it needs to be by now. Open world games like Red Dead Redemption 2 needs to be minimum 60 FPS. And if it can do like maybe 4K 60 FPS, at least 1080p and 60 FPS, at least. It has to. Come on. I understand the quality and everything probably what matters to them the most, because marketing wise is strategic, right, for marketing. And anything you can showcase your game that looks fantastic, obviously a lot of people are going to be willing to pick up the game, compared to what like a cartoony stand for it, or maybe different art styles as well. Now, I'm not saying, for example, that these games are not worth picking up. No. Indie titles are still fantastic games, and even if they have different directions with the art style, as an example, right? The Outer Worlds, a lot of people consider it to be more of a realism approach, but still indie moments in there, and that's cool. I like it personally. I like The Outer Worlds. I'm still playing it, by the way, still thinking about going for a platinum trophy on that, and I thought it was a great game, and still is a great game. I'm not gonna deny that. But of course, the Obsidian are gonna be developing games now for the Xbox solely, well, and a PC of course. But I'm not too distracted. I'm not too upset about it, because again, it's coming on PC, so I'm gonna have my hands on the PC. Plus, it still is a better experience on the PC compared to any consoles, of course. Like anybody who asks, where is it better to play your games, on a PC or console? And of course, everybody would say their own preferences, because on consoles is easier. All you need to do, turn on the console, hit the play button, you're good. You're good to go playing the game. On PC, it's a lot more complicated. It's not always hit the turn on button and hit the play button on whatever game that you choose to go with. Sometimes you need to be updates. Now, don't get me wrong, consoles have updates as well, but they're still very straightforward. Sometimes there could be issues on the PCs, as an example, the gadgets, the equipments. I should probably rephrase that. They had their own problems. That's an issue, in my personal opinion. But still, it's very complicated in some parts. Now, what's good about PC as well is because of the mods. Xbox, PlayStation, they really don't have these sort of mods, and like not up to the degree as the PC has. And because of this, there's so many of these choices that you can make your games look and feel so much different compared to what it initially launched at. And that's what makes it refreshing for you to come back to the games that you have already played before, and it's still so much fun to do so. Now, and it's just that's the thing. Hellblade 2, I'm not so much, you know, saddened by it because it's coming on Xbox and the PC, sorry, exclusively, because I'm still gonna get it on PC. Now, of course, that also depends on the reviews, because I usually play my games on the PlayStation, so I can't exactly say, for example, that if the game is gonna be bad reviewed, why would I be bother picking it up on PC then, you know, if the game isn't gonna be that hot, for example. Alright, well, I think I've mentioned absolutely everything that I wanted. I kind of went overboard a little bit in some parts. Hopefully you could understand what I'm trying to get at, and hopefully it was entertaining as well. But thank you so much for watching. Like and subscribe. See you guys all, and have a good one.